Monday, Monday, boo, Monday, 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 boo, Monday, Monday. Happy to be back, baby.
Monday?
Do you know how bad the USA Gymnastics is with all the sexual abuse allegations? I'm gonna tell you about that today. Oprah getting accused of conducting an inappropriate interview with the Olsen twins in 2004. The next big streaming service is Paramount Plus, and Pop Quiz is back. I'm answering some of your questions. I'm Alex Clark, and this is Poplitics. This freaking guy, piece of crap, former USA Gymnastics coach John Gettert, blows his brains out sitting at a rest stop in Michigan because the feds were about to get him. He was going to be charged with 20 counts of human trafficking and forced labor resulting in injury, and one count of racketeering plus two counts of criminal sexual conduct and one count of lying to police. This sicko let team doctor Larry Nassar molest girls in the back of his gym and then lied to police about it. So all I have to say is, toodles.
He's a vicious scumbag.
Yeah, he is.
If you're looking for something good to binge and you want to know more about the sexual abuse that was deeply rooted in USA Gymnastics, you need to watch Athlete A on Netflix and watch At the Heart of Gold on HBO Max.
For me, he was like a friend that I could go to.
I really thought that Hugh had been helping me.
He was so good at being who he was.
I would text him almost daily.
We really loved him.
This is the Olympic doctor.
Wow. What have you done?
Can we just do a run through of all the people, places, and things the left has canceled so far? Great. Aunt Jemima, Washington Redskins, Paw Patrol, Uncle Ben, Gina Carano, Lando Lake Butter Lady, Mr. Potato Head, and now Oprah?
Pooping in a public bathroom is worse than a colonoscopy.
TikTokers dug up this old interview from 2004 with the Olsen twins, and she's getting slammed.
Okay, I know there's a new rumor that's recently surfaced. Has really upset you, right? You know, the one about eating.
Yeah, you know, people are gonna write what they wanna write. We try not to read the good or the bad, mm-hmm. because it just kind of comes with the territory. Mm-hmm. You know, either you're too fat, you're too skinny, and people are just gonna write what they...
What size are you, by the way?
Size?
Yeah, I was like,
I'm really sure.
You're not sure?
Girls, and
oh,
you know.
That's so interesting. That is so interesting. I'm like obsessed with size, and you're like, I really don't know.
Yeah, so some of the comments that she's getting are accusing her of being inappropriate and disrespectful. It was definitely blunt, but given the time period and the style in which all interviews were conducted, I don't think it's that shocking or horrible. I do wish we had more from the Olsen twins today, though. In fact, I think the Olsen twins may be the secret to jumpstarting the economy again. An appearance from them, an interview that's tell-all, we need them.
That's right. When super giant pizza, plain, nothing on it, and I'd like that delivered as soon as possible.
Do you think Oprah was acting out of bounds, or was that a fair question to ask since the weight and alleged eating disorders were all over the news at the time? Paramount Plus is the next big new streaming service. Did you know about this one yet? I'm so pissed off. I cannot even begin to tell you the obscene amount of money that I am spending on all these dang streaming services plus cable. And I have to do it because I'm hosting a freaking pop culture show, so I have to watch everything and know what's going on in the world. Every week they drop a new streaming service. Here you go. Pay for this. Pay for this. When will it end? This will all end up costing more than cable. Just watch.
Now I'm a homeless person.
So anyways, Paramount Plus is dropping a new Rugrats, which is huge, Cynthia. Boogie to the groove now.
Mister, talk to me for a sec.
I don't want any trouble, Angelica.
Do you see that new animation style they're using? It's disgusting. I can't even watch it. It's like nauseating. You know what's weird? When I was little, I couldn't watch Pokemon because the show made me feel sick too.
Gotcha! Pick that!
Paramount Plus also has a doc all about Wuhan when the pandemic first started called 76 Days.
Sorry.
skeptical about this. I'm just gonna be upfront with you. This film is supposed to be about the frontline heroes in China. You know, nothing that China ever co-signs is even real. I mean, are they gonna cover the frontline hero doctors that blew the whistle about what was going on there and were then disappeared? Several doctors vanished at the beginning of the pandemic and have either never been seen again or they just reappeared after several months missing, probably because they had been sent to re-education camps. And we can't count on Hollywood to cover any of this fairly because they're all being funded by the CCP.
I'm full on corrupt.
I don't come bearing great news today. If you've been hoping to become an influencer, your grandma has a better chance at becoming IG famous than you.
We're a generation of doers.
Not whiners.
And we're doing great.
Senior citizen gran influencers are the next big thing on Instagram. Batty Winkle, who's 92, by the way, she's like super famous, you probably know of her, and making $9,800 per promo.
Respect your elders.
Imagine only having a couple years left, and then out of nowhere, you become one of the most famous influencers in the world. She's working with brands like Misguided and Urban Outfitters.
Woo! Batty Winkle on the track. Stealing your man since 1928.
I wonder if she dresses like that all the time or it's just for show and then she looks like a normal old lady the rest of the time.
Mystery.
All right, it's been a minute, but Pop Quiz is back. Submit fun questions for me to answer by clicking the link in our bio. All right, Miss Madeline, you wanna know what my top favorite clothing brands are? Okay, brand is hard, but how about stores? Revolve, Rolas for jeans, All Saints, Culture of Life, which is 100% pro-life fashion brand, Zara, ASOS, Steve Madden for shoes, Nordstrom, and Bloomingdale's. I think that's 10.
Well, I wanna go shopping. I want some new stuff.
Miss Casey says, what is your favorite TV series? The Office.
This plantation. We're running low on greenbacks. And we're having problems paying the people who give us the seeds and the dirt. We can't pay them.
Michael, I can't.
Lily wants to know if I like gold or silver jewelry. Gold, definitely, almost always wear gold.
Gold! Oh, there's enough here for 10 trailers.
Angelina, she's a tiny little squirt. Wants to know, since you're currently starting to cook, what is your favorite recipe as of now? Half-Bake Harvest tiramisu cake. If you follow her on Instagram, she's great. Melanie wants to know if I'd be open to a Poplitics book club. Definitely, but I think we have a subgroup for that already, so you need to join the main conservatives group on Facebook and then click the master subgroup list in the announcements that are pinned to the top and then join the book club one.
See, that's the library.
What?
That's the library.
What's that?
Olivia wants to know if I refer to people by their preferred pronouns if they don't match their biological sex. Yes, I do. It's just a respect thing. You're not gonna get through to anyone if you're being disrespectful and trying to start stuff with them like that. Then they won't listen to you because they don't respect you, and so it's not worth it. Whether they wanna be called she or hippo, just do it and be kind and try your best to talk to them.
That's really nice.
Caden says, if you weren't in the radio/media industry, what other profession would you want to pursue? Okay, storyboarding show ideas for Nickelodeon cartoons or being a child forensic interviewer.
She's a witch, I tells ya! Burn her!
Haley says, I follow many conservative people on social media, but no one with other views. I hate hypocrites. So in order to avoid being in a conservative echo chamber, do you recommend anyone or a podcast or something that I should listen to? I think it's easy to find other views. I feel like because every influencer or celebrity pretty much posts left-leaning views, so I don't know who to tell you to follow. I mean, I see stuff from people with different views just because I like them, so I follow them, and then I happen to see how they feel about things politically. I mean, like Taylor Swift or Selena Gomez or something, for example.
They stand for everything we don't stand for.
If you have pop quiz questions for me, click that link in our bio and you'll find tons of other stuff there too. Subscribe to us on Apple Podcasts and Spotify. Leave us a 5-star review. Don't forget to like this episode. Let me know if you think Oprah crossed a line in that interview and share this episode to your stories. DM it to one friend who loves Rugrats. Millennial 90 babies unite. We're back tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific. It's Pop Culture Without the Propaganda every single day. I'm Alex Clark and this is Poplitics. Click below to watch yesterday's episode. Please subscribe, thumbs up, share this video, and ring the bell for notifications so you never miss the conservatee. And make sure you're following this show at Poplitics on Instagram for even more conservative content.